So I've been thinking a lot lately. Have you ever felt that you failed at something or a deal fell through because you either shared some information that you were not supposed to share too early, or you shared too many details with people you were not supposed to share it with, and that's why it was jinxed? Or the truth is, you can't even really be sure who to or who not to share things with and how much is really too much. I've been told by several people that I tend to keep a lot to myself and I'm hard to read because I don't share my thoughts with anyone. So most of the things that I end up doing end up coming off as impulsive or too sudden, like, where did this one to come from, you know? And the real truth is, I think a lot and sometimes even overthink the things I'm about to do because I almost always want to be able to justify why I do them. Hi, my name is Kwame, and I'm a documentary filmmaker and voiceover artist based in Accra. And you're welcome to my channel. It's okay. And this channel is my attempt to make sense of life and the human experience in general. And I am happy that you are here. Now, I don't know if this is deep-rooted in some form of superstition, or I should go with the scientific psychological explanation behind this phenomenon, where your intentions are not able to be accomplished because you shared some things with people. There is an explanation which psychologists refer to as the intention behavior gap, which is the space between knowing you have a task to accomplish and actually doing it. So we announce these plans to people, we only seek their validation about the task, and this feeling tends to mimic some form of accomplishment in our minds when reality is we have not done anything. Now, the feeling that others know that we are up to something in our lives and pat us on our backs or root for us, for example, makes us feel like we've done something when we actually haven't done anything. Now, that is the scientific explanation. But from where I'm sitting and thinking back on my experiences, I'm just gonna go with the negative energy and self-sabotage through overthinking. I know a lot of people know this feeling, especially in our part of the world, where the best way to safeguard your success at something is to keep it to yourself because, well, nipa e bad. So hear me out on this one. There are many, many instances or examples where jinxing of events or activities happen because we share too much too soon, or perhaps with the wrong people who may pass judgmental comments and fill us with more doubts than we need to even begin with. So people like that won't offer support or better alternatives. They just kill your fire. And there are those people who say, yeah, it's okay, it's cool. But, you know, secretly they hope that you fail so that they can remind you that you suck at whatever you try to do. Now, it's the reason why many people may no longer believe in New Year's resolutions, for example, where we tend to broadcast these humongous ambitions while lacking the actual mental fortitude to go through with them, or not knowing the amount of work and unforeseen circumstances that may be awaiting us. So if you know yourself, just don't lie to yourself. Yes, I mean, the essence of maybe wanting to share the thing or do the said thing is to become a better person, but advertising and or broadcasting it to people who you want to maybe use as your unofficial accountability officers may not actually really care about what you want to do, or even remember it until you fail and they remind you of the noise you make without seeing actions through. So you don't need to tell people. Typical example is how I get ahead of myself knowing it's difficult for me to stick to something without losing interest and wanting to move to the next thing. And I've been putting off getting back in shape for the longest time. And my excuse was that I was busy with the 9 to 5 and I didn't have the time, the right clothes, and all the excuses in the world. So I did buy them. However, when I finally decided to quit and manage my own time and activities as a freelancer, I still wasn't doing it. And the truth is, maybe I didn't really want it that badly. If I did, honestly, I would. So 1 month into this quarantine, I mean, it became important that we took care of our bodies better, especially knowing that underlying conditions can decrease your chance of beating an infection due to a poor immune system. And after about a week of consistency with some exercising, I started broadcasting the activities to people who had been trying to motivate me to get back in shape, saying that, look, I'll be back in 6 months. Just give me 6 months. You guys will see. Let's just say that it's been 3 months and not much has changed because I keep falling out and restarting. So maybe next time what I'm going to do is just keep it to myself, hold myself accountable, and do it for me to prove to me and only me that I can and I will. As far as I've come to learn from another YouTuber on the same topic of conversation, there are about four kinds of people. Those who talk the talk and don't walk the walk. Those who talk the talk and walk the walk. Those who don't talk the talk and don't walk the walk. And those who don't talk the talk and actually walk the walk. And a place you want to be is group four. Don't talk, just walk it quietly and do your own thing. But that's just one part of this jinxing your progress theory. The other one, or the one I just mentioned right now, it's about your personal resolutions and ambitions, and they all lie within your control. And then there's the transactional type that has mostly to do with work and contracts and collaborations and whatnot. And sometimes there's a hint of a job or a gig that might be happening, but it's not fully confirmed yet. And, you know, I get it. You're excited. You want to share it with people and perhaps also feel like you're up to something or you're picking moves. So this is to seek validation, in my opinion. Actually, it's nobody's business unless it's directly affecting them. Like the new job is in a different region locally or maybe in a different country. Then you may have to prepare them mentally as they deserve to know. Otherwise, keep quiet and do your business. That's all I'm trying to say. Lock it in, leave it to discovery later on. The other person this may not work with may be your spouse because, well, you have the moral obligation to share. However, there may be even things that require non-disclosure and you can't still share with your spouse. For me, I'd gone through all these kinds of moments for so long that I started to believe that it might be tied to some form of superstition, and which is why I referred to it as negative energy in the beginning. And I actually believed it. Based on this theory, I decided to hold back a lot when it came to probable gigs and transactions till they were signed and done and like fully aware that I can have it. And this one happened with one big thing that happened in my life with my first ever job or radio internship in 2012. The actual beginning of my journey till now. So in September 2012, after job hunting for what seemed like eons without success, I mean, I decided to give something I'd been holding back for a long time a try. And it was more of a decision based on survival than that of passion at that point. And that was to go into radio and do radio school. So I applied, I got in, I started this 8-week course, and every time I left home to go to class, I knew this was it. I mean, I had to get this done or I'm done. I was hungry for success. Part of the school's offer also was to help you get internship placement after the course. And that was with some radio stations they had affiliations with. So after about 3 weeks of completing the course, that message came. And I'd been selected as one of the 6 people to submit my audition CD and interview for an internship slot at a radio station. And it was so exciting, but I decided to keep quiet until something came of it. So every day I would dress up and leave home with the excuse of, you know, going to pick some moves, which wasn't very, very suspicious because my brother and I had been looking for work and whatnot. So it was more like something we had to do. So for 1 week, I went to this radio station, first the interview, then the aptitude tests, then second interviews, then recording tests and all of that, till I was finally selected officially. That is the evening I came home and I told my mom, who was overwhelmed with emotion. So it was our win, I would say, because she was the one person who pushed this agenda through and through. But even her, I didn't told her about the interviews and I just did it for me. I learned from the onset to keep a lot of my ambitions and things I wanted to work on to myself. If I failed, I learned better ways to do it. And if I did succeed, the success will show up. Now, I don't really know the real psychology behind this. I can't really explain. Although scientists have tried to do it or explain it. But all I've come to learn is if you want something, do it for you. You're more likely to follow through when no one is watching and the pressure is only on you to prove what you're capable of. It isn't always the case though, if I should say. I mean, sometimes telling people can increase your chances of success when those people end up pointing you to better ways of getting there by connecting you to enablers or maybe they themselves helping you. So it's a tricky thing. And all I'm saying is, look, have your own ideas, do something about it. When you run into a wall, then you may share this and try and get help. If you really want something, the universe conspires to help you see it through. Maybe it's superstition, maybe it's not, but hey, work quietly, don't stop, and make sure you have fun while you're at it. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Of course, I almost forgot that one. It really helps. So yeah, I'll catch you again another time on this channel. Adios.